week two, habit two. Your assignment is to take your Great with God reading and put it at the very start of your day. I'm not certain if you've been reading Great with God at lunch or dinner or sometime during the day when it just fit into your schedule, but the next habit is to actually begin to develop a morning routine. Maybe you've already been doing that, so it's not that big of a change for you, but the goal is for you to start each day in the Word, and it's worded in such a unique way. We want you to start each day on your knees. So literally, we're asking you to get on your knees, and I'm just sitting right here, but the idea is just very simply to turn your chair or your bed or your sofa into a little altar. So get on your knees and begin to pray and start off even before you open up your book. I want you to spend you got 15 minutes worth of devotional. Take the first 2 to 5 minutes on your knees. What are you doing on your knees? Well, I'm asking God for help. Lord God, you are my source of insight. Would you come be my teacher today? Holy Spirit, would you come give me insight today? Normally, I spend a little time repenting. I say, God, you know, I'm sorry I didn't get that right yesterday. Would you have mercy upon me? Sometimes I take a little time to give thanksgiving. The idea is not to stay down on your knees forever and ever, but you can. But I'm just saying the first 2 to 5 minutes, asking God for his strength, thanking him, repenting of things that you know that you grieved him with, and then get back up and now open up your Great with God. So there you have it. That is habit number two. One of the questions we want to answer here is why habit number two? And that very is simply this: seek God first. The scriptures are clear on this. It says, seek ye first the kingdom of heaven and his righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you. There's a number of verses. Seek him early, and those who seek him will find him. The why behind this is very simple. How can you give your whole day to God unless you give the first part of your day to God? I use the illustration of a concert violinist. And can you imagine in your mind at the end of the concert, he says, everybody, if you would just remain seated and if you'll just quiet down real quick, I want to tune my violin. Well, no one would say that at the end of the concert. The instruments are always tuned before the concert. And so why? Well, it's important that we spend time with God, get in alignment with his heart, get in alignment with his spirit, get in alignment with his word and his character and his nature, so that we can be tuned up and ready to go and live this life for him, that he might live his life through us. And so this is the why. Why is because we want to be ready for every good work that God may have for us. We want to get in touch with his spirit so his spirit can live through us and speak the truth in love through us. So what are some of the hurdles that you might be faced with as you begin this challenge of really putting God at the first part of your day? Well, one of the things is that if you're actually accessing Great with God through an iPad or an iPhone, then you're going to have the temptation of just trying to, when you wake up, there's little alerts there that want to say, okay, go to Facebook or go to Instagram or check your email or check your text messages. All of that, you have to use a little bit of self-discipline here and make sure that you don't want to do anything like that until after you've done your morning routine. So give that first part of the day to God and make sure that you can engage those. Another thing that's liable to happen to you as you do this is I'll find sometimes my brain is just flooded with things to-do lists that I've got to do. And sometimes it becomes such a block. I just can't think of anything else because I'm afraid I'm going to forget that. Get yourself a piece of paper, get a pencil, and this is just called your things to-do list. And if it comes to the point where try and do your things to-do list later, but if it won't let go of you, then the best thing to do is to write it down, put it over there, get back to your devotional, get back to your praying. And so that's just it. You're just going to have to be aware that the whole world, and particularly this world of technology, is going to be trying to vie for being the first part of your day. And for you, you simply have to make up your heart and mind, say, nope, God first, and there's room for that later. Thank you, and God bless you.